It's a brand new headache for the Congress leadership and especially the Gandhis, this time from Karnataka. After Punjab, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, now in the southern state, they've got a fresh controversy, and it's in the form of a viral video, a clip in which two senior Congress leaders sitting in front of microphones, if you can believe it, were caught on camera gossiping, mocking, bad-mouthing no less than their own boss, State Party President D.K. Shivakumar. Take a look at what happened.
Is D.K. Shivakumar a drunkard? D.K. Shivakumar has increased bribes. D.K. Shivakumar is only after collecting money. It doesn't get more embarrassing than this. Two leaders of the Karnataka Congress caught on camera gossiping away about their state chief, D.K. Shivakumar. This is the media coordinator of the Karnataka Congress, Saleem, and former Lok Sabha MP Ugrappa, busy ranting about Karnataka Congress chief D.K. Shivakumar. Mind you, these are no small fry. They are two top leaders of the state Congress going all out against D.K. Shivakumar, unaware that the microphones in front of them were switched on all along. The BJP is having a field day with this video, with one leader after another mocking the Congress over the admission of corruption in the party.
Two senior functionaries of the Congress party, Mr. Saleem Ahmed as well as Ugrappa, are heard discussing Mr. D.K. Shivakumar's corruption. Now, Mr. D.K. Shivakumar, after all these allegations have been made against him by his own party men, as KPCC president, will he step down?
After making the Congress a laughing stock, the party has cracked the whip and expelled gossiper-in-chief Saleem for 6 years from the party and issued a show cause notice to the other leader, Ugrappa.
This was something they have spoken or someone has tried to whisper in some ears, which is no way connected to me, and Mr. Ugrappa has already clarified on that as far as that issue is concerned.
Former Lok Sabha MP Ugrappa, meanwhile, offered a weak clarification, hoping perhaps that he too doesn't face the same fate.
ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನತಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಯವರು ಈ ಇರಿಗೇಷನ್ ಇಲಾಖೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಹಗರಣಗಳ ಹಿನ್ನೆಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಪಕ್ಷದ ಮುಖಂಡರ ಮೇಲೂ ಸಹ ಗೂಬೆ ಕುಳಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಅಲಿಗೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನನಗೆ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬರು. ನಾನು ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಅಂತ ಹಂತದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಇದನ್ನು ಮಾಡದ ಆಯ್ತಪ್ಪ ಬಿಡಿ.
Once again, the infight between D.K. Shivakumar camp and Siddaramaiah camp has come out in the limelight with Congress own office bearers talking about D.K. Shivakumar and his activities and also supporting Siddaramaiah while they're having the cup of chai and media was recording it. But however, the party directions are that Ugrappa will have to come out and clear his statements to the public. Nagarjun Dwarkanath for India Today.
Well, before we go into our political face-off, obviously some, relevant lessons from this entire very embarrassing episode. First of all, you know, maybe don't badmouth your boss. And if you must, certainly don't do it in front of 11 television microphones centimeters away from your mouth while you're doing it. I mean, beyond the levels of stupidity, apart from everything else that you can take away from this. Joining me live, S. Prakash, spokesperson of the BJP, Syed Asad Abbas, the political analyst. The Congress party refused to be on this. Syed, I mean, you know, the first instinct is to laugh at this video. It's funny, it's hilarious. I mean, it's facepalm worthy. I mean, what were these guys thinking, talking about their boss sitting at a press conference? Apart from saying he's a drunkard and all sorts of very rude things about a respected figure like D.K. Shivakumar, that's separate. We're not even talking about all that. They get into all sorts of other things like, you know, bribery and 10% and all. So they get into some very serious things, Syed. So your opening words on this video.
Certainly, Shiv. As for a matter of fact, you know, D.K. Shivakumar, the currently Congress KPCC president, let me tell you, is one of the most hardworking and a very dynamic leader, which has rattled the Bharatiya Janata Party. Now, what happened between former Lok Sabha member, Mr. V.S. Ugrappa, and the KPCC media cell coordinator, Mr. Saleem, is nothing but loose talk. They are basically bad-mouthing a person. Next, Ugrappa comes in and says, no, we are only saying what BJP said about
these guys are not small fry. Like you said, Ugrappa is a former MP, senior leader. Saleem is a media coordinator. I mean, these guys should be knowing better than to, you know, let their mouths fly at a press conference.
There is no doubt about it. There is absolutely no doubt about it. Firstly, it is very sorry state of affair for Ugrappa, who's actually merely speaking a line or two. It is Saleem who comes into the fact.
Which is why Saleem has been expelled and Ugrappa has been given a show cause notice. But Syed, you know, by saying that this is what the BJP thinks seems like a, you know, very flimsy kind of excuse. To any lay viewer, this would look like real fault lines and indiscipline and a breakdown of structure within the Congress party. What does the BJP have to do with this?
I'll tell you precisely what. You know, the fact of the matter that Ugrappa had to hold another press conference and come out with a certain clarification. And also, if you saw the D.K. Shivakumar interview, you know, your channel also covered it.
Yeah, we did.
Nagarjun covering and asking question. Ask the right question. He was asked, you know, the fact of the matter, where D.K. Shivakumar said that nothing of it is attributed towards me. I have nothing to do with it. Congress will function its way. The disciplinary committee headed by Shri Rehman Khanji has expanded.
But you know, these are all brave faced things. This is a serious thing. D.K. Shivakumar's name is taken no less than 6 times in that small little soundbite. You and I both know this, Syed. S. Prakash, Mr. Prakash, bringing you in on this. What do you think? Obviously, the BJP is relishing this fresh, eruption within the Congress party. You know, you're making a big meal out of the embarrassment of your rivals in Karnataka.
No, it's their own party leaders are exposing their KPCC president. Mr. Ugrappa, as you said, is a former MP. Several times he's nominated as the MLC. He was heading it, some board also.
Yeah, he's a big guy. He's
such a responsible person. And he's all along the spokesperson of the party for quite a long time. And the person who was sitting next to him is Mr. Saleem, is a media coordinator. They were not speaking some cock and bull story there. They were speaking about a serious issue pertaining to Mr. D.K. Shivakumar. They clearly said Mr. D.K. Shivakumar increased the commission from 8 to 12%. These persons who are all agents of the previous government are well aware of how much commission they were collecting, how much these people were benefited out of it. And that has come out. And Mr. Ugrappa went on to say, Takadi Melilila. That means the weight of the DK Shivakumar has not gone up. He has remained a pedestrian president for them in the state. Is it not a serious issue to be pondered over by the party?
Sayyab, this is a brand new headache for the Gandhis also, because this shows indiscipline. This shows that I have only 60 seconds left. Only 60 seconds left, Sayyab. Yeah, it also shows that nobody cares about the rules. I'll say what I want about my boss. I don't care. I'll do it even at a press conference.
Shiv, I just have one line to share with my good friend and senior S. Prakash ji, you know. Aaj toh bahut khush honge aap. Now, coming to this topic, Shiv, firstly, I don't think it has anything to do with the Gandhis. Firstly, because M.A. Saleem, the coordinator, who's made most of the allegations, has no proof whatsoever. If he believes and thinks that D.K. Shivakumar is, let him go and file a complaint. Whereas, matter of fact, BJP is no good sheep, my friend. There is a video of Anand Kumar and Yediyurappa clearly talking approved by forensic lab video where they speak of bribing their leaders in the Delhi. So there is a video of
Mr.
that.
Mr. Abbas, please don't peddle lies.
Just 10
please
seconds.
Don't peddle lies.
10 seconds.
You 10 claim seconds. You're a political
person. I'm out of time.
Don't speak like a Congress spokesperson.
Sir, 10
please
seconds.
Be truthful to your conscience.
I'll hear you patiently.
There is a serious...
I have only 10 seconds left on the show.
Party member
10 seconds, sir. Allow me to...
Yeah, speak. We can hear you.
The BJP on the mat. I'm sorry. Are you a commentator or a Congress party worker? Please clarify.
Allow me... Sir, you can't...
No, what alone?
This is not
no,
your
how
channel.
Can you make a baseless allegation again?
Finish your point. Okay. That's it. I'm out of time. 10 seconds. 10 seconds, Sayyab. 10 seconds.
Okay. There is a video. There is a video of Yatnal, who's blamed Yediyurappa and his son for corruption, calling him a puppet chief minister.
We've seen what has happened to Mr. Yediyurappa. I understand what you're saying.
I think you should take the membership of the Congress.
But he wanted a ministerial post.
Those things.
Take up the primary membership of the Congress party.
Sayyab is right when he says there have been lots of conversations which have been recorded. But I am just saying that today's story, and I think you're right, what you said, Sayyab, is right, which is that aaj toh BJP bahut khush honge. The misfortune of your political rival is always going to be a source of mirth for a party, no matter which way you actually slice it. And today the BJP can in some ways sit back and with a bucket of popcorn and watch the discomfiture of the Congress party. We'll have to see where it goes because serious allegations were made. We'll have to see whether complaints are filed or whether we've heard the last of Mr. Ugrappa and Mr. Saleem. Briefly, it has lit up television screens, but that's the way it rolls with the Congress party these days. Thank you very much, Mr. S. Prakash and Sayyab Asad Abbas for joining me on this short discussion.